Hey guys, just wanted to say thanks so much for 800 subs. It's been a very nice adventure with you guys so far. I hope you guys actually enjoy the videos that I will make in the future. And now, remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and I hope you guys enjoy this little Skyblock guide. Hello guys, welcome to this Skyblock tips and tricks video. In this video, I'll be showing you guys how to start out on Hypixel Skyblock. Minor building tutorials like the OP hobby generating and stuff like that, and I will talk about really about I talk a lot about stuff like minions, which are a big part of Hypixel Skyblock. So the first step of the day, you should only get minions, or mainly go for the minions that you actually care for. So for example, in early game grinding, you want to go for iron, diamond, maybe even a redstone if you're into talisman stuff. Otherwise, minions like the wood minion is always nice if you like to have a little bit of wood and houses around your island. And of course, mob minions for grinding out some set pieces to things I'll mention later. Now, so this is recorded live. I will guys now show you how to upgrade your minions without losing your fuel. So let's say I want to give this block of coal to my minion, and it's my the minion's gonna be enchanted and it's gonna be diamonds. So I'm running over to my minion over here. As you guys can see, I'm putting the fuel into his slot right now. It's a you can I if I try to pick him up, it will say like, do you want to destroy the fuel, or it will destroy the fuel. So if you want to keep your fuel without doing anything to it, you can click next tier and it will show you what you need. So in this case, it's 2 stacks of enchanted diamonds. I can just click on the head and he's upgraded to tier 8. As we just learned about fuel and how to not get rid of your fuel while upgrading minion, the most important thing now that you remember now know is that you can actually spend a lot of money on one minion fuel wise and not have the fuel get deleted if you're trying to upgrade. So this you should, for example, in this case, we have the enchanted lava bucket. It's the best fuel in the game. And so we actually can keep upgrading our minion without losing it, because it lasts forever. It costs quite a lot. It makes your minion work 25% faster, but it gets deleted if you picked up the minion. But in this case, we don't. So you know what this means, boys. Usually you do not want to put enchanted lava buckets on things that you're gonna use for a little bit. For that, you use catalyst, which I'll get onto next. Next off, we as previously mentioned, we have the catalyst. The catalyst is a long-term, very effective thing that you can give to your minions to make them work better and faster. The catalyst increases the number of resources created by the minion by 3 times for 3 hours, which is about 3 in-game Hypixel days. It's crafted with 8 endstone, normal endstone, and 1 crystal fragment, which the crystal fragments are supposedly dropped out of ender chest enderman in the end by in the end island, or it's dropped by the enderman that spawn in while fighting a dragon. Now this is live again. Yeah, I will show you guys how to, without any compactors, mostly only the basic compactor, this is how you usually, the quickest way to turn things into enchanted versions. You grab, for example, a couple blocks. In this case, I'll grab 3 for length's sake. Crafting table, shift click, shift click. I'm holding shift the entire time. I'm not letting go of shift. Boom, I can now put it away. Next off, we are gonna talk about collections. So collections, as we all know, are basically our collection of everything, single thing we have collected so far. For example, most things in Hypixel Skyblock have their own collection, which have their own custom items. For example, I don't know, diamonds. At tier 7 or 8, was it? You get hardened diamond armor, which is one of the best mid-game armors, according to me at least. And it just takes a lot of time to collect some of these things. For example, you need 15,000, I think, for hardened diamond to unlock, and then you also have to get the enchanted diamond to craft the armor. So as I said, collections are very important. I can't really tell you guys that much about collections as there's nothing much to talk about, but I can definitely tell you guys how to start out with collections, as in early, mid, and end game. In early game, you will want to farm diamonds, iron, cobble, redstone, and obsidian. We want to get diamonds for future hardened diamond armor, which is one of the best mid game armors. We are gonna farm armor, iron, so we can get the golem armor, which is a very balanced, in my opinion, armor, and the golem sword, which is one of the best mid game weapons. We want to farm cobble just to get that little bit. It's starting to prepare for the cobble generator later on. And also, if you like stone bricks in your skyblock builds, which I do. Redstone, by leveling up redstone in the collections, you get a bigger and bigger talisman bag, which you can put. It's actually an accessory bag now, yeah. You can put accessories now into it, which you will not waste your inventory space. And obsidian, so you can get a better ender chest upgrade, which ender chest is your personal ender chest you can open anytime through the skyblock menu, and it just basically gets bigger over time with the collections. In mid game, you want to farm ender pearls, spider eyes, string, cobble, redstone, and obsidian. Cobble, redstone, and obsidian for the same reason the last time. But you can actually replace the cobble minion with a cobble generator, which I'll get on later. And for ender pearls, at 15,000 ender pearls, you get the you unlock the teleporter trait, which lets you set up teleporters to teleport from place to place on your island, as well as crafting the aspect of the end, which is one of the early end game swords. Spider eyes will be used for slowly building up to the best, one of the better swords in the game, which in this case is leaping sword. It's one of the top tier weapons. It's made out of about 200,000 worth of spider eyes, as well as some minor ingredients. And then you can also get string, so you can actually easily get grappling hooks. At 15k, you unlock grappling hook crafting recipe, which you need free enchanted string, which is 9 stacks, and then 2 sticks to make a grappling hook. You can make easy money out of it from this. Then we have the end game. In the end game, you want to be farming pig, fish, redstone, glowstone, and possibly still ender pearls and spider eyes. And pigs, because obviously one of the best later end game weapons is the pigment sword, which requires about 250k worth of pork chop / pigs. Well, it's one of the best weapons, but it's also the most time consuming. Also, so you can get piggy banks, which are a very nice part of the game. You can use also fishing minions to get an easy money while you're offline. Fishing minions are very useful, as you can get fishing talismans / accessories, which you can easily reforge for some free percentage on crit chance and stuff. You will continue to farm redstone, but for another thing, which in this case will be enchanted redstone blocks for super compactor 3000s. And also redstone lamps to make potions, and as well glowstone to make potions. And also possibly continue to farm ender pearls and spider eyes for the swords and keep selling them. So now we're moving on to the OP cobble generator. As you guys know, getting cobble with minions might be a little bit too little for you guys each time you guys log on. So here's a way that you can mine super quickly. On Minecraft Hypixel, you can mine out cobblestone very quickly, about an entire stack for 3 to 4 seconds with these things. You need full miner's outfits armor, and it's miners, not miner, just make sure you guys know that. Which the full set bonus is haste. It gives permanent haste too while worn. With this haste combined and the Stonks pickaxe, which is gotten from the End Island, you're able to do this. Crazy, right? So I'm about to show you how you guys do it. Now that we're on creative, I can show you guys how to build one. I will use golden pressure plates as teleporters. So this is going to be one teleporter. Now we're going to build a 14 block wide strip. 14, all right boys. Now you build a little thing going up here on here on this side. You can make anything this out of any block as long as it's not flammable or turns into, for example, or ice, for example. So on the, on this side, we want to get a block that we can place trapdoors on. It can be anything. There's no see-through block that lets you do that. So for example, in this case, we can do quartz. It's preferred to not use a mineable, easy to mine thing, but it's going to make it look a little bit better if you're just be more careful. So you place an entire strip of another block here. It doesn't have to be another block, but it should be. So you place down your trapdoors. The trapdoors will be here to prevent any mishaps. And once again, you place one block there, and then build a thing right here. A little like trap cage for this. Now we take this cage up and we build up 7 blocks. So 4, 5, 6, 7. And then repeat it. Now that we have done that, we can let that be for now. Then on the other side, we do the exact same. Now where we're on this part, we're going to build another little cage around this. Now, we basically place water on each of the, it has to be each of those. On each block, we place one water. So there's nothing like unequal. Preferably don't do it in a snow biome. I'm going to place glowstone really quick, so it doesn't smelt. You guys don't have to do any of this unless your thing else is your biome is also you set your biome to winter if that's a thing. Actually, I'm not sure. Now on each, so you play, so it's 5 times 14. You're gonna need a lot of lava buckets, so just be prepared. You place each of those, and you should do it as quick as possible, or do it from below, from below down, because it makes it way more easy. I had a few mishaps with this, so you guys know it is possible to, you know, screw up. In this case, most things have. You can hop in here to clear any holes that you might have missed by accident, which you just right click and place lava in the missing spots. And now you should have it work. Now it should work for you. This is how you build an OP cobble generator. Now we'll talk about fairy souls. As you guys don't know, fairy souls are a very big part of the game. When you're up on higher tiers of the game, so if you done a little bit of skill, leveling up skills. So these are my skills, if you guys are wondering. So you guys can look at my crit chance, compare that stuff. So with just my fairy souls, I have a base health of 464 HP, 58 defense, a 45 strength, 303% speed, 36 crit chance, 50% crit damage, and then 16 additional intelligence. You may wonder, how do you get them? You go to how do you find out about them? You go to this area called the wilderness, which is over here. It's a huge tree. That's how you should know that you're close. Over here we have Tyr the Fairy. You will be able to talk to her. I've already talked to her, so I don't have anything to exchange, and yeah. Your fairy souls are found all around the map, but if you guys need to, I will link a Time Dio video in the description, so you guys can watch him get all the fairy souls and you guys can follow along. It takes about 2 hours to get all the fairy souls in the video. They're glitched, of course. Now, we're also going to talk about reforging, which reforging is also a big part of Hypixel Skyblock for getting extra damage in. So, you talk to the blacksmith to open the reforge menu. You can see it says reforge item. Each item that has different rarity, as you guys can see, it says epic, rare, uncommon, and common. Common costs the least at the 250 coins, then uncommon costs 500, sorry. Epic, 1,000. Rare, 1,000, and epic at 2,500. The best the best reforge for bows is rapid. For armors, it's either godly or strong, which I have access to strong for now. And for swords, it's spicy. Otherwise, you can, if you really need to, other focused things, you definitely should take like other ones, but these are the best according to most people. Now, moving on to the tricks portion of the guide, we have the secret mob armor set bonus. The mob armor consists of the skeleton's helmet, guardian chestplate, creeper pants, and spider's boots. First off, we're going to go with the skeleton helmet. The skeleton helmet gives you 75 defense, and as well the ability gives you 3 little bones that basically take a full hit for you, and each of those can regenerate over every 30 seconds, or you can take the helmet off and on to reset the bones, which they haven't fixed yet. Next we have the guardian chestplate. It gives 50 defense and gives an additional 20 HP. And if you're at full health, the armor is going to completely nullify any damage taken for dealt to you if you're full HP. And the cooldown for said item ability is 60 seconds. It's the easiest craft of the bunch, but in my opinion, it's a really nice armor. Then we have the creeper pants. It gives you 200 HP and 65 defense. The ability causes an explosion when you drop below 20% HP, damaging and knocking everybody back around what is around you. And the cooldown for the ability is 60 seconds. And last but not least, you have Spider's Boots. It gives you plus 5 speed, plus 45 defense, and plus 50 in the intelligence. And it's the item that allows you to double jump, which in Technoblade's video on Flying Skyblock, it's the main part of said video. Sorry, I forgot to mention. If you have the full set on, you actually take 25% damage, 25% less damage from any enemy, and you deal another extra 25% damage to any enemy you hit. Another very cool thing is with grapple and the aspect of the end, which makes me be able to teleport for 50 mana. I can use grappling to get to places I want and go. It's more of a vertical thing, and AOT can give you just a little bit of height you might actually need mid flight. As you can see, I will show you guys how you can use that for your advantage, and it's actually a pretty nice thing you can do. If you just walk up here, now using the grappling hook, they can throw it forward, launch yourself. Aspect of the end, launch yourself again. Now you're at the hub while being in the server of the spider den. This means there's nothing functional in here. Did I just go through that thing? Or that? No, that was just lag. Okay. But now you can go out here and explore the hub in its full glory. Not any people interrupting you. There's no NPCs, but there are some interesting things, like these are filled codes with a head in them. And it's a part of the game that they actually do not do much about. As I don't remember this pig being here, at least, for example, in this case. You have the lumberjack, this is offset, for example, there's no map in here. You still can't destroy anything, you can't destroy anything though, so yeah. There's two things in Iron Freight though, which is interesting. The custom... The custom table is still here, actually. That's interesting. I can't use this enchantment table. I can't use this anvil either. And the most things are also replaced with sponges for some reason. If anyone knows why, leave a comment below. And here's the portal to the deep caverns, which won't work obviously, but it still has the barrier blocks. So this is a fun thing I just wanted to show you guys. Now that we're actually back at the normal spider den where people are, we can take our grapple and possibly aspect of the end to over to this place, which you need combat level 12 to go use this portal, but it's totally worth it. Now, I didn't mention it to you guys, but I will now show you how to get easy money in the end without even touching the Enderman. If you walk around for long enough, you guys see a little a particle effect around blocks, which I will speed up the footage. The footage will be sped up until I find one. As you guys can see, they have this little some sort of crit like particles. And when you mine them, and I'll just create an inventory real quick for you guys. This time the pool can go away. If you mine it, it gives you 5 mining XP, and in this case it did not give me any money, but sometimes it does. It gave me 500 pearls, 16 net stone, and one magical rune, which is can be used at level 12. I'll try to find one more to show you guys how much money it actually can give though. There we go, that's another one. So this time it's an obsidian block. It doesn't change much besides possibly dropping just another thing. So I will quickly mine this out. I got 300 coins, which is pretty little in this case, but we got experience bottles. So that's one thing. And then we got enchanted ender pearl. This is technically very little. That's about a stack of ender pearls. You can't use it because it's a enchanted item as usual, but you can smash open the experience bottles for free XP. That's what I want to show you guys in the end.